In a previous video, we discovered the number one most anti-inflammatory food. But in this video, we're going to learn the second most anti-inflammatory food. And I guarantee you'll be surprised at what it is. There's no way I would have guessed that it was this food item that comes second. And I say food, but actually it's a beverage. And spoiler alert, it's not coffee, green tea, or hibiscus tea. Because of the state of the world and current environment we're living in, now more than ever, we need to be consuming foods that provide specific plant chemicals that can prevent cellular stresses, inhibit inflammatory signals caused by the immune system, and to promote a healthy gut microbiome. And chronic low-grade inflammation is known to be a contributing factor to numerous health problems. Not only can an anti-inflammatory diet help reduce the risk of chronic diseases like heart disease, diabetes, and certain cancers, it can also help manage symptoms of conditions like autoimmune diseases, arthritis, inflammatory bowel diseases, etc. An anti-inflammatory diet can also improve our blood sugar, cholesterol, and triglyceride levels, as well as boosting mental health and cognitive function. So now we're going to hear a brilliant clip from a recent Q&A in which Dr. Greger is addressing someone who's asked about their high CRP levels. Now, CRP is C-reactive protein, and it's said to be one of the most accurate and useful markers of inflammation that we can do in a blood test. Dr. Greger really goes into depth on this one, so if you'd like to skip to the answer of the number two most anti-inflammatory food, you can go to the minute showing now on the screen. But I highly recommend you listen to the whole clip, as this could help you or a loved one who might have to deal with high CRP levels in the future.
Been eating a whole food plant-based diet for 10 years, yet still have high CRP, C-reactive protein levels, which is a marker of inflammation in the body. First of all, as always, treat the cause, right? Maybe there's some underlying inflammatory process. Ideally, we would treat first. But if your physician just cannot figure out why you have higher levels of inflammation, you can certainly try eating an anti-inflammatory diet, which is not just a plant-based diet, which is basically synonymous with an anti-inflammatory diet, but one that decreases saturated fat, not all of which are from animal sources, right? Tropical oils, palm kernel oil, palm oil, coconut oil, has saturated fat, which increases inflammation. Trans fats, dietary cholesterol, all increase inflammation. And then there's all sorts of anti-inflammatory foods. The most anti-inflammatory food component, number one, is fiber. So we're talking the drier whole plant foods like legumes and whole grains, particularly groats. And then flavones, actually, are the second most anti-inflammatory food component, which are found concentrated in chamomile tea. You can give that a try as well.
Two other foods high in flavones are parsley and celery, with red bell peppers lower, but still an honourable mention. Next, we'll learn about 10 other incredibly anti-inflammatory foods, some of which are unexpected. To view that video, you can click the middle of the screen now.